Buenas tardes a todos. Estoy alegre de estar ustedes hoy en Chicago.
It's great to be here with you. It is such an honor to have a chance to come and be with La Raza, and I want to talk to you about three things. I want to talk to you a little bit about Virginia and the important role of the Latino community in Virginia. We have some great applause here. I want to talk to you about my role as chairman of the Democratic Party, and I want to talk to you as a friend of the Latino community. Yo viví en Honduras por un año, hace 25 años. Yo trabajé ya como un misionero, and estoy trabajando juntos con la comunidad latina en Virginia y en toda la nación ahorita. Pero thank you for the invitation, Janet and others. To Janet first, thank you for your wonderful leadership, and to Raul for his wonderful leadership of this organization for many, many years. To Dan Ortega, the new chair, it's so good to be with you, and to have all of you here talking about the important issues in La Raza, which is one of the very preeminent civil rights organizations in this country. There have been some interesting words said about La Raza in the last few months, but I'm here to express my thanks for what you do as an organization. Give yourself a round of applause for the great work that La Raza does. Es importante también hablar sobre un vote, o hay un vote de proporciones históricos in the Senate Judicial Committee, 13-6 for our next Supreme Court Justice, Sonia Sotomayor. In my home state, Virginia, the Latino community is quickly becoming one of the most influential communities, not just in Virginia, but in the nation. 1 in 10 Virginians were born elsewhere, and a sizable majority of those from Latin American countries. And in fact, about 20 years before English settled Jamestown Island, the first Spanish settlers arrived near Williamsburg. It didn't last very long, but they were at least there first. So we've had a long history of interaction with the Latino community. I have been proud as governor to put members of the Latino community in key positions in government, especially the head of our elections department, the secretary of our state board elections, Nancy Rodriguez, is the first Latina to serve in that position. And throughout my administration, we have many, many leaders. The thing we're most proud of in Virginia in working with the Latino community is the wonderful educational performance of Latino students in Virginia. We have more than 87,000 English as second language students in Virginia. And recently, the National Assessment of Educational Progress, known as NAEP, the Nation Report Card, reported that Virginia was first in the nation in performance by Latino students in the elementary school grades. I certainly learned in my time in Honduras that the Latino community is a comunidad de fe y familia y trabajo y educación, and we are working with the community on educational matters in Virginia. In fact, we've closed our achievement gap between English learners and native English speakers from a 21% gap down to 9% in the last few years, again, because of great achievement and performance by our Latino students. I know you're talking about educational issues today. It's very important to recognize great things are happening, and we all want to be part of them. I thank the NCLR for great projects that you're working on. First, in Virginia, NCLR is working with our East Coast Migrant Head Start Project, important early childhood education, the Hispanic Committee of Virginia, Marcelino Pan y Vino, which is a great community organization in Northern Virginia, and the Shirlington Employment and Education Center. And I have two Virginians, Lenny Gonzalez and Andres Tobar, que están aquí hoy de SEEC, doing great work in our community. And what you've done has been magnificent to Janet and the leadership. Your two campaigns, Ya Ahora Ciudadanía y Ya Ahora Ve y Vota, to encourage people to become citizens and vote. Get this, La Raza has been part of registering over 200,000 new voters to take civic responsibility seriously. And I was thrilled at this, over 1.5 million individuals who are legally eligible, La Raza has worked with them so that they can apply and move through the citizenship process. Give yourselves a round of applause on that great achievement. It's safe to say that our president, President Obama, would not have won Virginia votes or the nation's vote without the strong support, the apoyo del pueblo latino. Y quiero dar mis gracias para el presidente, porque él entiende el apoyo y él da gracias también. Thank you for your support. Gracias. Very quickly, my role in my other line of work as chairman of the Democratic Party is to focus on three things. El éxito del presidente, presidential success first. Second, building up a grassroots movement to support positive change in important areas like health care and immigration reform and energy. And finally, working with state parties. Cuando vive en Honduras, fuera un military gobierno. Y nadie puede votar para nada hace 25 años. Y Honduras tiene tiempos dificultades ahorita. It's important to have a strong two-party system. I am proud to be the chair of the Democratic Party, and I want the Republican Party to be strong, too. It works better if both parties are strong, and that's what we need to work on together. So at the Democratic Party, we're working to do all kinds of things to promote presidential success. We've seen pay equity for women, insurance for low-income American children. 11 million are now getting insurance because of SCHIP reauthorization. We are putting great people in place, Latino leaders in the administration and in the DNC, including our Director of Community Outreach and Voter Registration, Cindy Benavides, who is with me today. I got some Cindy Benavides fanáticos in la casa, ¿verdad? But the thing we're most excited about is this grassroots movement, organizing for America to make great things happen. It will be the involvement of all, just as it was in the campaign, that will enable us to make significant success. Let me say algunas palabritas sobre una cosa muy importante, la reforma de las leyes de inmigración, immigration reform. This is a matter of great importance to all Americans. I want to reiterate what the President has said, that he is committed to comprehensive immigration reform. It's needed, and the wheels are already in motion. The American people want this in a bipartisan way. Recently, the President met with congressional leaders on the issue. Our Secretary of Homeland Security, Janet Napolitano, who many of you know from her time as governor of Arizona. Janet is heading up a task force to make sure that progress is moving forward. While that dialogue is taking place, let me tell you what is happening at the national level. First, the FBI is working to clear up a huge backlog of immigration background checks that were holding up the legal immigration process. We're working to do that to make the process more customer friendly. DHS and the Department of Labor are cracking down on employers to avoid employee exploitation. Citizenship petitions are starting to move more quickly through the DHS process. The U.S. Citizenship and Immigration Services officers and other administration officials are working to create a website where all can track the progress of immigration applications. All of this work is consistent with our foundational values as a country, that we're a nation of laws, but we are also a nation of immigrants. We need to respect that and we need to honor it. Let me say one word about health reform. I know you heard the Valerie Jarrett, the President's key advisor, talk about it earlier, but this is un asunto muy importante en la comunidad latina, ¿verdad? Uno de cada seis americanos no tienen seguro de salud. Pero uno de cada tres latinos que no son retirados no tienen seguro de salud. Es un importante, es un asunto muy importante. And it's time now for us to make a difference so we can do what other industrialized nations in the world have done and provide a fair and cost-effective system that provides basic health care coverage to all Americans. Americans support that. I believe La Raza supports it. And we are going to do all we can to see that that president's vision, which is also your vision, becomes a reality this year. Please help us in that effort to find a better health care future. Well, and now to the most important topic, la tema de hoy. In May, with the announcement that Judge Sotomayor would retire, that Justice Souter would retire, our president took on one of the most important things a president does, the nomination of a Supreme Court justice. I don't think there is any doubt that the president selected the right person for the job. And so today, the Senate Judiciary Committee has voted for her nomination. We at the DNC have worked on this historic nomination. Thousands of people have demonstrated their enthusiasm for Judge Sotomayor's nomination with help for Organizing for America. And it has given me an opportunity to usar mi español. Now, mi español no es perfecto, ¿verdad? Yo viví en Honduras hace 25 años y necesito practicar más. Pero hay algo más que hice luego de su nombramiento. Practiqué mucho mi español durante las entrevistas que hice por televisión y por radio. Creo que el esfuerzo valió la pena. La jueza Sotomayor tiene una historia personal impresionante. Ella triunfó ante muchas dificultades. Como ustedes saben, se crió humildemente y su mamá trabajó sumamente duro para darle una buena educación. Y así, poco a poco, siguió superándose con sus propios esfuerzos. Luego de estudiar en una escuela católica, obtuvo una beca para estudiar en Princeton. Ahí tuvo más dificultades porque fue como un nuevo mundo para ella. Pero trabajó más y más como latinos en todas partes, graduándose con altos honores, abriéndose su pasa hacia la Escuela de Derecho de Yale, donde editó la revista Yale Law Review. Creo que ya saben cómo va el resto de la historia. Luego desempeñó un papel excelente en Cortes. Y en el día de hoy, está a solo pasos de ser confirmada a la Corte más alta de esta nación. ¡Qué historia! ¡Qué buena historia! Para mí ha sido un placer apoyar al presidente Obama en su nombramiento de la Corte Suprema. Es parte de lo que hago en el DNC. El DNC, entre otras cosas, es el brazo político de la Casa Blanca. De hecho, es uno de los mejores sitios para ayudar al presidente y a impulsar sus planes de poner a la gente a trabajar nuevamente y ayudar a que nuestra economía se recupere. Y no hay duda, tenemos varias batallas fuertes por delante. And let me conclude there. There are so many battles that we will continue to fight this year. Political battles, the New Jersey and Virginia governorship. Next year, 36 governor's elections, 35 elections de senadores, cada posición en el Congreso. But we are going to work to produce results, to be a good partner, to find solutions that Americans care about working with La Raza. None of it will happen without a fight. Like I said earlier, we want both parties to be strong. We want both parties to work together. But we won't hesitate when the other party doesn't offer solutions but just says no. We won't hesitate to call them out on being a party of no. We need to be a people who will work together to find solutions. And when folks who just say no get in the way, that is part of my job as well, to point that out and work to find solutions. Pues, I'll close. You have a lot of speakers left, and I want to thank you for the opportunity to come. I can't tell you what an honor it is to do these jobs, but what an honor it is to stand before you and pledge to Janet and your board and to the entire membership of La Raza that in the coming years I will work to be a great partner. We will work together to achieve President Obama's agenda, and we will keep this country true to its origins as a country that welcomes in a wonderful way the experience and skill and abilities offered by our immigrant communities and especially by our Latino community here in the United States. Thank you very much. Vaya con Dios.